Today, let us discuss about general pharmacology. In general pharmacology, first let us discuss about definition of pharmacology. What is pharmacology? Pharmacology is a branch of pharmacy which deals with the study of drugs and drug effect and body response towards the drug. Pharmacology is a branch of pharmacy which deals with the study of drugs and drug effect and body response towards the drugs is called pharmacology. And this pharmacology is combination of two Greek words, that is pharmakon plus logy is pharmacology. Pharmakon means drug and logos means study. In combination is called study of drugs is called pharmacology. And next let us discuss the word drug. What is drug? Drug is a chemical agent in which whose structure is known to us which is used under three conditions. First one is diagnosis. And prevention. And treatment. These are the three conditions in which the drug can be administered. What is diagnosis means? It is the test which is used for the confirmation of disease, can be done by x-rays. And prevention can be done by vaccines. And treatment can be done by antibiotics. And this is about drug. And second, let us discuss about drug effect. Drug effect. Whenever the drug which is administered in our body, the drug will show two types of effects. One is desirable effect and other one is undesirable effect. One is desirable effect and other one is undesirable effect. This is positive effect and it is negative effect. This desirable effect includes diagnosis, prevention, and treatment. Diagnosis, prevention, and treatment. And this undesirable effect includes side effects. And adverse effects and severe effects. This is the effect of the drug in which whenever the drug is administered into our body, it will show two types of effect. One is positive effect and other one is negative effect. Positive effect is called desirable effect and negative effect is called undesirable effect. This desirable effect includes diagnosis, prevention, and treatment. Undesirable effect includes side effects, adverse effect, and severe effect. And let us discuss about body response of drug. this body response of a drug includes two subdivisions. That is first one, pharmacodynamics. And second one, pharmacokinetics. Pharmacodynamics and pharmacokinetics. What is pharmacodynamics means? Pharmacodynamics is a branch of pharmacy in which it explains about the what does the drug do to the body. Pharmacodynamics explains that what does the drug will do to the body when it is administered into the body. Now what is pharmacokinetics? Pharmacokinetics is a branch of pharmacy which explains about how the body will get responded whenever drug is administered into a body. Body response towards the drug. This is about pharmacodynamics and pharmacokinetics, which are subdivisions of pharmacology, and this is basic introduction of pharmacology. And let us discuss about pharmacodynamics. What is pharmacodynamics? Pharmacodynamics is a branch of pharmacology which explains about what does the drug will do to the body. What does the drug will do to the body will explained by pharmacodynamics. Whenever this drug is administered into our body, it will show two types of effects. One is desirable effect and undesirable effect. This desirable includes diagnosis, prevention and treatment, and undesirable effect includes side effects, adverse effect and severe effect. This is about pharmacodynamics and pharmacokinetics. What is pharmacokinetics? Pharmacokinetics is a branch of pharmacology which explains about how the body will be responded towards the drugs. Now, this pharmacokinetics includes four subdivisions. First one, absorption. Second one, distribution. And third one, metabolism. And fourth one, excretion or elimination. Whenever the drug which is entered into our body, the body will get responded, and the body will show four types of responses, that is absorption, distribution, metabolism and excretion. Now, whenever the drug which is entered into our body, like oral, whenever the drug which is entered into our body through the oral, let us consider this is the drug which is either solid or liquid, whenever it is taken through the orally, first that is it will enter into the gastrointestinal tract and will be entered into the stomach, where disintegration will take place and result in formation of small particles in the gastrointestinal tract, and from here it will reach to the blood circulation. It will reach the blood circulation. This is about absorption and distribution. What next one is distribution. Whenever the drug which is present in the, this is the content of the drug which is present in the circulatory system, which is absorbed. Now it has to transfer or it has to distribute to the different parts of our body, like heart, kidney and liver and muscles. Now this is about distribution process. And what is metabolism? Whenever it is distributed into the different types of, like heart, kidney and liver, muscles. Now this metabolism, what is metabolism means, let us consider this is the heart. And here this is the heart. Whenever this blood will be reached towards the heart, and metabolism, the process of conversion of one form of, the process of conversion of one form of drug into another form of drug is called metabolism. It is also called biotransformation. That is biotransformation and excretion. Out of these four, excretion is the important factor, that is, and after metabolism the drug has to eliminate from our body through different process, that is like from the urine and through the lungs. And through the saliva and through the feces. This is about response which is shown by the drug in our body, that is absorption, distribution, metabolism and excretion. And if we discuss about these four in detail, first one is absorption. What is absorption? Let us consider a drug, either it may be solid or liquid dosage form, drug which is administered into our body, and it will get absorbed and will enter into the blood. Whenever this absorbed drug which is entered into the blood will be in two forms, one is free form and other one is binding form. One is free form while other one is binding form. And if the drug which is absorbed in the free form can show its action, but drug which is in binding form with our plasma proteins cannot show its action, and it will
convert into free form and it will show its action. This is about absorption. And if we discuss about factors which are influencing the absorption, the factors which are influencing the absorption is, first one, it involves pharmaceutical factors. What are pharmaceutical factors? These pharmaceutical factors includes formulations and disintegrations, dissolutions and next one, particle size. These are the four criteria which is based on pharmaceutical factors. First one, formulation. Formulation is nothing but it includes what are the components or medicaments which are present in the dosage form, that is medicament. It includes formulation and disintegration. Now here let us consider, this is the drug. This is a drug which is administered orally or parenterally and it will reach the gastrointestinal tract. It will reach the gastrointestinal tract. Now where it reaches to the gastrointestinal tract, with the help of the enzymes, it will get converted into the smallest particles. This is called disintegration. Now, when it undergoes disintegration, it results in next one, that is dissolution. It get dissolved in here. It will be dissolved in the blood. And next one, that is particle size, and the size of the particle will get decreased. And these are the factors of pharmaceutical factors which are related with absorption. And second factor, that is drug relating factor. This drug related factors includes lipid solubility, and pH and ionization. These drug related factors includes lipid solubility, pH and ionization. And let us consider a drug which is to be administered into our body. Now the drug which is administered into our body should be lipid soluble. If it is lipid soluble and it can be passed through the membrane of our cell easily, and if we discuss the pH will play an important role in the absorption. If we take acidic drugs, it will get absorbed in the stomach, and if we take basic drugs, and it will get absorbed in intestine. This is a difference between the pH, that is acidic and basic. And if we consider the ionization about absorption, if a drug which is administered into our body, if it has to get absorbed, then it should be in unionized form. Unionized form of drug can be absorbed easily. This is second factor, that is drug related factor, and the last factor, that is biological factors. What are biological factors? Biological factors includes surface area and gastric emptying time. If the surface area of the drug is very less and it can be absorbed easily, this is about first one, that is absorption in pharmacokinetics. Second one, that is distribution. Whenever the drug which is enter into our body will get absorbed and will get distributed to the all parts of our body, like heart, kidneys and liver and muscles, etc. Now, what are the factors which are regulating this distribution? Is first one, blood flow. Blood flow is the first factor which is regulating the distribution process. That is, if the blood flow towards the this is the first condition in which the blood flow is more, and second condition, that is blood flow will be less. The organs in which the blood flow will be more is heart, kidney and liver. And the organs in which the blood flow will be less is muscles, that is skeletal muscles and adipose tissue, in which the blood flow towards these muscles will be less, and ultimately the distribution will be less. And this is the first factor. And second factor is capillary permeability. Capillary permeability. Now, this capillary permeability is also important factor in case of distribution. It is based on junctions between the cells. If there is more space between the cells of this capillary, then there will be passage of distribution. Let us consider, this is one cell. This is a liver cell. Let us consider this is a liver cell, that is hepatocytes, in which there is a space between the capillaries. This is a space through which the blood can flow outside and inside. This is about capillary permeability and in liver. And let us consider one more cell. Is ganglionic cell, in which there is no, these are the ganglions, in which there is no space between the capillaries and there is no flow of blood into these cells, and ultimately there is no distribution of drugs in this condition, and there is a distribution of drugs in this condition, that is capillary permeability. And third factor is increases blood flow and capillary permeability. And next one, redistribution. As we discussed that these are the organs like heart, kidney and liver in which the blood flow towards this kidney, towards these organs will be high, and whenever in this area metabolism takes place, some amount of the blood will get retained in this area, and that retained area, that retained blood will get distributed to the other tissues. This is distribution. And next one is lipophilicity. What is lipophilicity? The drugs which has to be distributed should be lipid soluble. This is about distribution, that is second process. And next process is metabolism. Metabolism is also called biotransformation. The process of conversion of one form of drug into another form of drug is called metabolism. And if we discuss about the result of metabolism, there are three results, in which first one is inactivation. Whenever the activated drug will be entered in our body and undergoes absorption process, distribution process and enter into the metabolic phase. Now the activated drug will enter into the liver. This metabolism will take place in liver mainly, and this activated form of drug undergoes metabolic process and results in metabolite. Active metabolite of a drug. Now, whenever this drug will release the active metabolite, now this metabolite will be inactivated. Whenever the drug which is entered into the metabolic phase and it will release the active metabolite, now that active metabolite will get converted into inactivated form. Example, paracetamol. And propanol. These are the two drugs in which comes under this category, that is whenever the paracetamol is metabolized and it will show effect on liver if it is accumulated in our body, and so the active metabolite of paracetamol will get inactivated. And this propanol is also beta blocker. The metabolite of this beta blocker will get inactivated in order to decrease the effect of beta blockers in the heart. This is first one, that is inactivation, and second one, activated form of active drug. Second result is activated form of active drug. Here the drug whenever it undergoes metabolic process, a metabolite will be produced. Now that metabolite will be in active form. Here the metabolite will be active form. So it get converted into another form. Example, allopurinol. Will get converted into alloxanthin. And second example, codeine will get converted into morphine. Codeine will get converted into morphine. This is example of activated form of activated drug. And third result is activation of drug. It is activation of drug whenever the inactive form of drug, that is called prodrug, whenever the prodrug is administered into our body, they cannot show it action. Now this prodrug will get converted into active form of drug and will show its metabolic process and will show it pharmacological effect. Example, dopamine. Whenever this dopamine is secreted from the substantia nigra of midbrain, now this dopamine will be inactive form and they cannot show its action in its activated form. So as a result, levodopa is a drug which is given to our body. Now this levodopa is an inactive form of dopamine. Now this levodopa will get activated and will activate the dopamine and will increase the dopamine effect. Here dopamine is secreted from the substantia nigra of midbrain. Now whenever dopamine will get decreased in our body, levodopa is a drug which is given to our body. Now this levodopa is inactive form of drug. This levodopa will get activated and now this levodopa will get activated and will activate the dopamine and will resulting in the activation of dopamine and will result in decrease of Parkinson's disease. Parkinson's disease is because of low dopaminergic action from the substantia nigra. This is about three forms: inactive, activation and active form of active drug. These are the results of metabolism. And if we discuss about the enzymes, which are involved in the metabolism, there will be two forms of enzymes. One is microsomal enzymes. And other one is non-microsomal. Microsomal enzymes are the enzymes which are present in the microsomes of liver. It is present in the microsomes of liver. And non-microsomal enzymes are the enzymes which are present in cytoplasm and mitochondria. Which is present in cytoplasm and mitochondria of the liver. This is microsomal and non-microsomal enzymes. And this microsomal enzymes requires NADPH and cytochrome or oxygen. Microsomal enzymes requires NADPH and oxygen. Examples for this microsomal are NADPH, cytochrome P450 reductase. NADPH, cytochrome P450 reductase enzyme is example 5 microsomal enzymes. And second, that is non-microsomal enzyme, that is xanthine oxidase. And alcohol dehydrogenase. These are the two examples of non-microsomal enzymes, xanthine oxidase and alcohol dehydrogenase. And NADPH, cytochrome P450 reductase is the example of microsomal enzymes present in the liver. These are the enzymes which are involved in metabolic process. And if we discuss about the phases of metabolic process, there are two phases. That is phase 1 and phase 2. In phase 1 is also called non-synthetic phase. It's called non-synthetic phase. What is the function of this phase 1 metabolism is? It will convert the lipid soluble drug into water soluble drug. As we discussed that the lipid soluble drugs will get distributed easily throughout the body. Now in phase 1 metabolism, the lipid soluble drugs will get converted into water soluble drugs, and whenever it converted to water soluble drugs, it will enter into the kidneys. That is nephrons, and will remove outside through the urine. Will be removed outside through the urine easily. This is phase 1 function, that is lipid soluble drugs converts into the water soluble drugs and will enter into the kidneys and will enter into the nephrons and will participate in urine formation and will excrete out through the urine. Now this phase 1 includes oxidation, reduction, hydrolysis and cyclization, decyclization. As we discussed that lipid soluble will get converted into water soluble by oxidation, reduction, hydrolysis, cyclization and decyclization. First let us discuss about oxidation. As we know that oxidation is removal of electron and addition of oxygen. Removal of electron will be positively charged and addition of oxygen will be negatively charged. And if we discuss about the enzymes which are involved in oxidation, will be first one microsomal oxidation, is an oxidation in which takes place in the presence of enzymes which are present in the microsomes are called microsomal oxidation. And second one is non-microsomal. Non-microsomal oxidation is an oxidation which takes place in the presence of enzymes which are present in the cytoplasm and mitochondria of liver. This is about oxidation. And if we discuss about reduction, as you know that reduction is gaining of electrons and removal of oxygen. Gaining of electrons is negatively charged and removal of oxygen will be positively charged. And this is second phase, that second process through which lipid will get converted into water soluble, and third one, that is hydrolysis. Addition of water molecule is hydrolysis. Addition of water molecule is called hydrolysis. Example, phenytoin is reacted with water, will convert into hydroxyphenytoin. Phenytoin will get converted into hydroxyphenytoin. Now, if we discuss about microsomal oxidation, this microsomal oxidation is internally divided into three subdivisions. Hydroxylation, and sulfur oxidation and dealkylation. Addition of hydroxyl group is called hydroxylation, same phenytoin, that is, and S sulfonyl. Addition of sulfur group to the oxygen is called sulfonyl oxidation. Example, cimetidine is reacted with sulfur, will form cimetidine sulfoxide. That is cimetidine sulfoxide. And next one is dealkylation, removal of alkyl group from the dealkylation. And this has three subunits, that is hydroxylation, sulfur oxidation, and dealkylation, which is involved in microsomal oxidation in phase 1 of metabolism. And this is hydrolysis and reduction. And these are the steps which are involved in phase 1 metabolism. Now, if in phase 1 metabolism, if drug fails to metabolize and it will enter into the phase 2, what will happen in phase 2 means, it will undergo conjugation process. When conjugation process undergoes completely, this lipid soluble drug will get converted into water soluble drug and will undergoes metabolic process. And last one, that is excretion. Now, excretion, as we discussed, that the drug which undergoes absorption, distribution, and metabolism has to get excreted from our body. There are several ways to excrete from our body, that is saliva, sweat, and through carbon dioxide, and through feces, and through urine, etc. These are the ways in which this drug can be, waste form of drug can be excreted out through the saliva, sweat, and through respiration, and through feces, and through urine. This is about pharmacokinetics. If we discuss about bioavailability of, that is bioavailability, bioavailability of drugs. What is bioavailability? First definition. The rate and extent of drug. Rate and extent of drug which is absorbed from its dosage forms. The rate and extent of the drug which is observed from its dosage forms is called bioavailability. Now, the main function, the main aspect of this bioavailability is to decrease the time and to increase the productivity of bioavailability. That is, to decrease the time and to increase the productivity. Now, let us consider first case in which if we take oral tablet, it will enter into the windpipe, it will enter into the esophagus, and it will enter into the stomach, and will enter into the intestine, and will be excreted out. Now, so to take place all these events, it is time consuming process. In order to decrease the time, there are special drugs, that is intravenous, which is given to the blood intravenously. Now, whenever it is given intravenously, then it undergoes metabolism easily and will be excretion easily. Time will be saved and productivity can also be increased. This is the main motto of bioavailability. Now, let us discuss a graph. Here, this is a time, and here it is a concentration of drug. Now, there are two lines. This is MEC, MSC. What is MEC and what is MSC? MEC, minimum efficiency or minimum effecting concentration, maximum safe concentration, minimum effective concentration. Now, let us consider a case one in which there is a drug which is administered here. Before discussing about that, what is minimum effective concentration? Minimum effective concentration is a concentration in which the drug will be activated at that concentration and can be active at above that concentration. What is maximum safe concentration means? The concentration at which the drug is highly safe, and beyond that the drug cannot be safely administered. Now, let us consider case number one in which the drug is administered. This is administration point and it is elimination point. This is case number one in which it is not beyond the minimum effective concentration. And let us consider drug number two. This is effective administration and this concentration. Now, this drug has passed the minimum efficiency concentration and they do not pass the maximum safe concentration. Now, this is appropriate condition. Now, let us consider case number three. It is beyond the minimum efficiency concentration and also beyond the maximum safe concentration. Now, this is case number three, case number two, and case number one. Now, the space which is present between these red two lines is called therapeutic index window. The space present between the MSC and MEC is called therapeutic index window. And now there is a point of concentration at which the drug can show its concentration or it will show its action rapidly. That is called T-maximum. T-maximum means therapeutic maximum, at which, let us consider, this is after 1 hour. at which the action of the drug will be high. And in case of bioavailability, there is one term that is AUC. What is AUC? AUC means, let us consider, this is the required drug that is, which is above the second condition, that is, which is above the minimum efficiency concentration and below the maximum safety concentration. This blue colored one is a area under curve, that is area under curve. AUC means area under curve. Now, and one more formula, that is volume of distribution. The formula for volume of distribution is amount of drug present in our body. Drug in body divided by concentration, plasma concentration. Plasma concentration will give the volume of distribution. This is about bioavailability of drugs.